In this video, we are going to look on how to create an Instagram quote image using Canva. So stay tuned. Hi, I am Torsten, and this is the first of a series of videos about Canva. And I'm personally using Canva a lot in my daily business, whether it is just to create some graphics or some other promotional material, and I'm planning to make a series on different topics about Canva. So if you have a specific topic or some kind of graphics that you want to see me create in Canva, just drop it below in the comment box and I will make sure that I will come up with it next. And to not miss any of these upcoming videos, make also sure to click the subscribe button and hit that notification bell to get notified every time I upload a new video. And now, without any further ado, just let's dig into the subject and let's create an Instagram quote image using Canva. First, let us find a quote that we are going to use. You can easily find quotes on sites such as brainyquote.com or wisdomquotes.com, or simply use Google. Don't worry about the URLs, I'll have them in the description below, so make sure to check them out. For this tutorial, I'm going to use a quote from a blog post on my site where I have 365 different motivational quotes, one quote for each day of the year. Now let us take the first one right away, which is, "If your ship doesn't come in, swim out to meet it," by Jonathan Winters. So I just copied this now to the clipboard so that we can use it later on. If you are going to create more than one Instagram quote image, you might want to copy and paste several quotes into one text file. Now that we have a quote to use for the Instagram quote image, we need to find a picture that we are going to use together with it. A site that I often use to find great and royalty-free images is pixabay.com. You can find their free images and videos that you can use anywhere. Also, this link you will find in the description below. And if you use any other sites to find royalty-free images, just put them in the comments below so that others can use them as well. In Pixabay, we are searching now for a picture that suits our quote, and I will enter the search term ship. And there we find some nice images. I think we can straight away go for the first one. So we click on it, that it opens, and then click on the green free download button on the right. There we can now choose the size that we need, and in our case it is 1920 by 1279, which is big enough. So we make sure it is checked before we click the download button. This will download now the picture to our computer. And now we have everything we need. So let us hop over to canva.com to put everything together. Now we are on the dashboard of Canva, where you can find all your previous designs and also, of course, start a new one. The easiest way to start a new design is to click the Create a Design button on the upper left corner. This will bring you to a page where you can select the design you are planning to create, or you can choose custom dimensions if you need a graphic in a particular size. For this tutorial, we will stick with the social media designs and choose the Instagram post. It has a size of 1080 by 1080 pixel, which is exactly the size we need. Once we click on it, a blank canvas will open. On the left-hand side, we see different templates for different niches, where we could select one from it if it fits. But in most cases, you want to create your own design, and this is what we are going to do now. So we will first upload the image that we downloaded before. And for this, we click on Upload in the left menu bar, and then we click Upload an image. In the File Explorer, we choose the image that we have just downloaded and click Open. This will upload the picture to Canva. From there, we just drag and drop the picture on our design. You have two options. Either you drop the image just somewhere on the canvas and then you resize it according to your needs, or you bring the picture just over the edge of your Canva and it will be automatically used as background and resize accordingly. In our case, this is the option I want to go for, so I just drag the picture over to the Canva and when I just cross the edge, I will drop it. Now it is the time to add the quote, and for this I'm going to choose text from the menu bar on the left. From here we can either add a heading, a subheading, or some text. But we also can add pre-designed text elements. Simply scroll through the entire list and see if something fits your needs. And here's one that seems to be suitable for us, so I simply click on it and it will be added to the canvas. We could move this now around where we would like to have the text, but first we need to edit it and add our own quote to it. So I click on the text element and then select all the text either with the mouse or using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl plus A. Once the text is highlighted, I paste the quote that we have selected before with Ctrl plus V. As we have copied everything, including the author, we simply highlight the text we don't need and cut it out with Ctrl plus X. This will not only delete the text, but also copy it to the clipboard so that we can use it again. And this is what we want to do now. We repeat the step from before and click on the author box now, or however you want to call the text element that holds the original author of the quote. Then we highlight the author either with the mouse or with Ctrl plus A. And then we paste our copy with Ctrl plus V. Now we have all the elements on the canvas, but it looks a bit boring, doesn't it? So we want to make it stand out a little bit more. And for this, I want to add another element behind the text so that it is also better to read. In the menu on the left-hand side, I will choose Elements for this. And there we can find a lot of different elements that we can add to our quote image to spice it up. But we want to keep it simple. We don't want to use any icons or photos or anything else. We will just add a shape that we can then drag behind the text. So if we click on Shapes, we will get all different types of shapes, whether it is circles, squares, hearts, or whatsoever. And in this case, we just use a simple square. Once we click on it, it will be added on top of our canvas. From there, we can drag it wherever we want it to be, and we can also resize it. First, I will drag it to the left side of the design. Then I resize it using either the handles in the corners or on the sides so that it covers everything except of the ship. Then we want to adjust the color to something that suits to the overall image. For this, we click the color button in the top left corner to bring out the color selection. Here we find the defined brand colors, the default colors, as well as any other color that we already used in our design. We can also add a specific color with clicking on the plus sign and choose the color picker or enter the hex code of the color we want to use. In this case, I will use one of the yellow-orange colors, maybe the middle one, so I click on it and the element will be orange. In the next step, we want to bring our text in front, or the element behind the text, however you want to name it. For this, we click in the menu on the top right on position and choose backwards on to bring the text in front. In the next step, we want to adjust the text, for example, to have a line break after the comma, etc. So we click the text element and this is a group. The quote element and the author text are grouped together. Depending on the changes you want to make, you might need to ungroup it with clicking Ungroup in the top right menu. For our case, it will be fine to have it grouped. I just changed the font size to 42. This will already have the line break behind the colon, what I prefer. If not, we would need to play around with font size or adding a manual line break if necessary. But if it is fine by the looks of it, we can drag the text now to a position where we want it. When dragging an object over the canvas, the horizontal and vertical pink lines will help you to find its position in relation to other objects or the canvas in general. The quote image looks already okay. Another thing that we can do is to add some opacity to our orange rectangle so that the background shines through. We can adjust the opacity by selecting the object and then clicking the button that looks like a gradient in the top right corner, and we bring the transparency down. A good value to start might be around 50, and I think it looks better already. One last thing I always do, and I would recommend you do it too, is to add some kind of branding to your Instagram quote image before you download it and upload it to Instagram. For this, you could add another text element that states your name or website URL. I usually add my logo, which is just a white T on blue and which I almost use everywhere. Now that we are finished with our quote for Instagram, we can download it. Simply click download in the upper right corner, choose PNG as file format and click download again. This will save your design on your local hard drive from where you can upload it to Instagram. If you don't know how to upload an image to Instagram from your computer, I got you covered. Just click this link there in the upper right corner. Now that's it. That's how you create an Instagram quote image using Canva. If you want me to create a specific design that you are interested in, please leave me a comment in the comment section below and I will make sure to address it in one of the upcoming videos. Also, make sure to subscribe to my channel in hitting the subscribe button below and hit the notification bell so that you will be notified every time when I upload a new video. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up. And now you can check out here on the left hand side how to upload an Instagram image from your computer straight to Instagram. This was Torsten. Thank you for watching. Take care and talk soon.